Welcome to another tutor short provided by the Educational Support Services Department of Lehigh Carbon Community College in Snecksville, Pennsylvania, which is just outside of Allentown. These videos review key learnings for the science courses provided here at LTRIC. And please remember that the Educational Support Services Department does provide walk-in tutoring 5 days a week.
Hello, Anatomy and Physiology 1. This is a tutor short on muscle part 4, the lower limb, which includes the thigh, lower leg, and foot movements, given by your tutors, Laura Heck and Kim Rylander. This image shows the part of the body in which we will isolate in this video, isolating all of the muscle groups of the lower limb. This is the anterior view of the right lower limb. Here you can see the sartorius, located here. The sartorius origin is the anterior superior iliac spine, and its insertion is the medial surface of the tibia. Its action is to flex and externally rotate the thigh. In this view, you can see the extensor fascia latae, located here, which is continuous with the iliotibial band, also known as the IT band. The tensor fascia latae, its origin, is the anterior superior iliac spine. Its insertion is the lateral condyle of the tibia, and its action is to abduct and flex the thigh. You can also see your quadriceps femoris muscle groups. This includes the vastus lateralis, the rectus femoris, and the vastus medialis, also the vastus intermedius. We will now go over those muscles. Here is your vastus lateralis. Its origin is the linea aspera, and its insertion is the lateral condyle of the tibia and the iliotibial tract. Its action is to extend the lower limb. Here is your rectus femoris. Its origin is the anterior inferior iliac spine and the superior rim of the acetabulum. Its insertion is the patella and the tibial tuberosity. It also extends the thigh. Independently, it flexes the femur as well. Here is the vastus medialis. Its origin is the linea aspera and its insertion is the patella. It also extends the lower limb. And beneath those muscles, we have the vastus intermedius. Its origin is the anterior and lateral surface of the femur, and its insertion is the patella. It also extends the lower limb. This is an anterior view of the left lower limb. We will now use this model for the rest of our muscle groups. To go back over some of the muscles that we've already named, I will point them out. Here's the sartorius. Here's the tensor fascia latae. Here is the rectus femoris. Here's the vastus lateralis and the vastus medialis. We will now move on to the adductor groups. This view is the medial view of the left lower limb. In this view, you can again see the sartorius. You can also see your gracilis located here. The gracilis origin is the pubic bone, and its insertion is the medial surface of the tibia. Its action is to adduct, flex, and medially rotate the thigh. You can also see your adductor longus located here. Its origin is the pubis, its insertion is the linea aspera of the femur, and its action is to flex and medially rotate the femur. And you can see the adductor magnus located here. Its origin is the pubis and the ischium, its insertion is the gluteal tuberosity and the linea aspera, and its action is to adduct and extend the thigh. This is the posterior view of the left lower limb. In this view, you can see your hamstrings. Here we have the biceps femoris. Its origin is the ischial tuberosity for the long head and the linea aspera of the femur for the short head. Its insertion is the head of the fibula and the lateral condyle of the tibia. And its action is to flex the lower leg and extend the thigh. You can also see the semitendinosus. Its origin is the ischial tuberosity, and its insertion is the tibia. Its action is to flex the lower leg and extend the thigh. And you can see the semimembranosus. Its origin is the ischial tuberosity, and its insertion is the medial condyle of the tibia. Its action is to flex the lower leg and extend the thigh. This is a posterior lateral view of the left lower limb. In this view, you can see the gluteus maximus. Its origin is the ilium, sacrum, and coccyx, and its insertion is the iliotibial tract and the posterior femur. Its action is to extend and outward rotation of the femur. And you can also see the gluteus medius. Its origin is the ilium, its insertion is the greater trochanter, and its action is abduction and medial rotation of the femur. This is an anterior view of the left lower limb. In this view, you can see the tibialis anterior, located here. The tibialis anterior's origin is the lateral condyle and the upper two-thirds of the tibia. Its insertion is the medial cuneiform and its first metatarsal, and its action is dorsiflexion and inversion of the foot. You can also see the extensor digitorum longus. Its origin is the upper anterior fibula, and its insertion is the middle and distal phalanges of digits 2 through 5. Its action is extension of the toes and dorsiflexion. And you can also see the extensor hallicis longus. Its origin is the fibula and interosseous membrane, and its insertion is the distal phalanx of the first toe. Its action is extension of the first toe and dorsiflexion. This is the lateral view of the left lower limb. In this view, you can see the fibularis longus. Its origin is the head and upper surface of the fibula, and its insertion is the fifth metatarsal. Its action is plantar flexion and eversion of the foot. You can also see the fibularis brevis. Its origin is the lower lateral surface of the fibula, and its insertion is the fifth metatarsal. Its action is plantar flexion. In this view, you can also see part of the gastrocnemius and the soleus. We will go over these muscles in the following slide. This view is the posterior view of the left lower limb. Here you can see the gastrocnemius. Its origin is the medial and lateral condyles of the femur, and its insertion is the posterior surface of the calcaneus. Its action is plantar flexion. And here you can see the soleus. Its origin is the heads of the fibula and tibia, and its insertion is the posterior surface of the calcaneus. Its action is plantar flexion. And in this view, the gastrocnemius and the soleus have been removed. So deep to them, you can see the tibialis posterior located here. Its origin is the tibia, the fibula, and the interosseous membrane, and its insertion is the navicular, the cuneiforms, cuboid, and the second, third, and fourth metatarsals. And its action is plantar flexion. You can also see the flexor digitorum longus. Its origin is the lower posterior surface of the tibia, and the insertion is the distal phalanges of digits 2 through 5. Its action is flexion of the distal phalanges 2 through 5. And you can also see the flexor hallucis longus. Its origin is the lower posterior fibula, and its insertion is the distal phalanx of the first toe. Its action is flexion of the first toe. Thanks for watching. To view these models, or if you have any questions, please come to SH150 in the Educational Support Services Center.